This one is clear? Yes. What about the value when we have the central point? Sum A sine equals x equals A over 2, the central point. Put this A over 2. So A will cancel, 2 will cancel, and we will have sine 5. And sine 5 is equal to 0. So we got 3 points here in this box where our wave function is equal to 0. So if I plot here, for example, let me go for some more waves here, and then we will see that whether the wave function is there or not. Let's say, let me check at a quarter point where x is equal to a over 4. Now, put x equal a over 4. This is actually a over 4 value. And what will be this value? This is a over 4. And this value is 3a over 4. Because it will become 3 times. This is a over 4. This is 2a over 4. Which comes out to be a by 2. And this one is 3a over 4, and this is 4a over 4, which becomes 1a, right? So let me check here on this way. When x is equal to a over 4, then a will cancel. 4 here simplified, this will pi by 2. And sine pi by 2 comes out to be 1. So again, we got the maximum value of the wave function, which is 2 over a. So let me plot, means in order this one to be there, let me plot that this is again your 2 over a. We should plot here at this point. But as we have already drawn this one here, so let's say this is again 2 over a here. And we got some values here. 0 here. 0 here and 0 here, but maximum at this point, right? Let's check sine and x equals 3a over 4, and we will come to know that at this point, 3a over 4, this will be 3 pi by 2. 3 pi by 2 is also 1. So we got that this is again 2 over a. So the 3 pi by 2 will become, I think, minus 1. So here it says that the value is actually like this. Because on a over 4, the value is maximum, which is 2 over a. And then on this point, 0. And then we are having the minimum of this value, which is like this. And it is a complete wavelength. Right? This was a half wavelength. This is a full wavelength now. And similarly, if I go on to sine 3 of x, then with this one, 1/2 will be added. So it will be something like this. This is sine 2, and then this one will be added with it. One more cycle. And we will have, like here, you can calculate in one cycle with this. While sine 4 will be equal to 2 complete cycles. It will be 2 complete cycles, and so on. So our wave function is actually like this. Start thinking?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So we got our wave function psi of n of x, and this is equal to 2 over a and sine n pi over a x, such that n is equal to 1, 2, 3, and so on. And this particle is having energy En equal n square pi square h bar square over 2ma square. These are the energies of this particle. We showed that if we plot x here and psi 1 of x here, then we will get like this, half cycle. If this point is A and this point is 0. If we plot x here and this is A here and this is psi 2 of x, then our wave function or our state of the particle will become like this. Similarly, if I plot psi 3 of x, then it will be like this and one cycle more. So this will be point A and this will be point 0. This will be point A, this will be point 0. So is this one I call the ground state, because this is the initial energy. This is the energy the particle will have as a built-in energy, ground state energy. And this will be equal, this lowest energy is equal to E1, and it is pi square h bar square over 2ma squared. This is the lowest possible energy. Lowest energy like a classical particle is not zero. And that's the difference between the quantum mechanics and classical mechanics, that how the lowest energy can be some energy. And this thing actually resulted due to the quantum confinement effect, the quantum effects, that you are confining the object, the particle, in a very short range. This one we will call is the first excited state. And this one is the second excited state. First excited state and second excited state, and so on. So the particle will have its state like this. Now these, the psi n's of x are actually very important. They are having some very surprising properties, that if you look to this one, then these psi n's are alternatively odd and even. Look here. This one is one cycle, so this is odd. Now this one is having this cycle as well as this cycle, and this is even. This one is again one cycle added with it, so odd. So the wave functions are actually a combination of odd and even functions. And you see here, it shows that the particle will not exist on the wall and the other wall as well. But in between, the particle is free to move. It has some value. If I want to find the probability of this particle, then this will come out the square of psi mod square. It will be this probability. Here the probability, this negative cycle will come up. Here in the probability psi mod square, this negative cycle will come up. So we will have three cycles here. Okay. Now three positive cycles here. Now, the odd and even, we will have to explore more that when I go from the first state to the second state, then I find that the nodes are increasing. How many nodes are here? There are two nodes here, the starting and the ending, and there are three nodes here. So the nodes are increasing. And when I come here, then they become four. So as the particle is going to more excited states, the number of nodes increasing. Now look here. It is not only that the particle will not be found on the walls, but the particle will also not be found here. Clear? If I just write mod square of this one, let's say the mod square psi 2 of x mod square, and this is x. So the first cycle is this one, and the second cycle will also come up because you are squaring it. When you square this one, then it will also come up, means the negative will become positive. So now at this point, means it was clear to us that when it will be in the ground state, the particle will not be found on the walls, right? But when the particle will go to the first excited state, the particle will also not be found in the middle as well. Zero probability. The particle cannot be in the middle of our box. Clear? This point is clear? Because here the probability is zero. The probability is increasing, and at certain point it becomes maximum, and then the probability start decreasing, and at the middle of the box in the first excited state, the particle cannot be there. While again it becomes more probable, and then it will come on the wall again to zero probability. When I come here, in the second excited state, this cycle will come up like this. So what does this say? In the second excited state, there are two more points where the particle cannot exist, where the particles will not be found. And this one, this thing is quite strange. And that's why this is called quantum mechanics, not classical mechanics. In classical mechanics, there cannot be a situation where a particle disappears or where there is no chance of finding that particle at a certain point. But when you come to quantum mechanics, then very strange things happens to the particle. Your box size is of the size of your particle. And that's the reason that quantum effects come in there. So it is completely different situation from classical mechanics. That's why I told you in the early part of this section that this is the very first example which make us understand the difference between classical mechanics and the difference between quantum mechanics. Like we say, the particle is here, it's a classical particle, it can be anywhere, it is moving, it can be stationary as well. Quantum mechanical particle cannot be stationary at all. But it can be here, and it cannot be here, it can be there, like this. So these steps are actually like this, that I told you that you are moving smoothly in classical mechanics. While in quantum mechanics, your both legs are tight and you will have to jump. Now, where you will have to jump, quantum mechanics will decide whether you can jump till here or not. So, to the particle, quantum mechanics will dictate.